This champ flick has begun. You've got to now pick and ban properly. Well, there's the fizz ban. So already, answer one is correct.
Well, yeah, that is a double ban. I guess you get double value out of that against Team Impulse. Shower using it last week as well.
TSM have learned what Impulse like to play.
Well, the crucial champion to me in the first week for Team Impulse was the Evelynn for Rush. And that is still on the board. Yes, Fizz and Yasuo were very big parts, but Yasuo was, I feel like, a really big part of the Yasuo success was due to the Gnar matchup specifically. And then the Fizz there for Xiao Wei Xiao is... What?
Sorry, I was wondering if the Ryze is going to come in or not, because I was, in my mind, I'm like, okay, so Evelynn's still up, and Ryze is still up as, like, two really important ones, and... Rek'Sai is still the grab, though.
Rek'Sai is a great pick against Evelynn, though, because of the Tremor Sense. You can see her when she's trying to come in for one of those ambushes. So he goes, skips right over the Evelynn. Then, all right, Rek'Sai is going to be classic Rush. Lee Sin, he's definitely been keeping up his practice on the champion as well. One of the main ones he used in Korea to grab rank number one over Faker.
Yep.
And he's bringing it overseas.
All right, the Lee Sin is back again in the summer split here in the North American LCS. Move had played it in week one, but now it's Rush's turn to prove that he is absolutely amazing, and I have faith in the player. Impact gets his Rumble, and TSM to make their next choice.
Yeah, you know, pretty much as scheduled here for Impulse. They've got early game pressure. They have mid-game teamfight prowess with the Rumble, so check, check for the classic Team Impulse playstyle. Should be... similar today. Also, since they saw no since they banned Yasuo, they are free to pick the Gnar for Dyrus. And we'll see how he does in the Rumble matchup. Once again, this is definitely a skill matchup. Can easily be tilted by jungler intervention. Both the junglers have premier early game junglers. So
yes, they do.
Let's take a look at that top lane jungle matchup, which is always very important in Impulse games. Rush and Impact, two of the strongest players for the team, and two of the guys that have really, really just worked together so well.
And we talked so much about the Team Impulse top jungle synergy, one that TSM almost doesn't have at all. So if you talk about matches being tilted, well, how about a 2v1 the entire time?
So I watched their show last night, and they said on the show that they spent an entire week, you know, practicing top priority style League of Legends, where they just gank top a whole bunch, that Dyrus be the carry. So, they said that they put in a lot of practice on it.
Well, speaking of things that teams put practice on, as the crowd chants behind us, Bard could be one of them.
That's the rest, a champion. All right.
Yeah. I'm just, you know, transitioning to various things happening around the stage right now. Sivir Thresh, though, still a great utility lane down here. This would be interesting. TSM does need some teamfight damage, though, with a bunch of tanks for the most part, and LeBlanc not known for her real 5-on-5 power. Maybe Wild Turtle does pick something with great cleanup.
Yeah.
We are on 5-10. There were some Jinx nerfs in the last patch.
Yeah. I always talk about, you know, chaos, quote-unquote, whenever we talk about Impulse playing. But really, the planning stages for planning to play against Team Impulse is one of the easiest. Because Team Impulse, you know what you're going to get. You're going to get the tempo game style. You're going to get the fast early game. You're going to get them pressuring, looking for tower dives, looking to transition into a mid-game win. So you know exactly what you're getting when you're going to face Team Impulse. And the question is, can you come up with the counter for it? They're looking for the Annie to set up a good Gnar ultimate. Mm-hmm. They've got Bjergsen on LeBlanc, the mid-game one of the easiest champions for mid lane to snowball with. Very, very prominent assassin here. Mm-hmm. And they're challenging Xiao Wei Xiao to that mid lane assassin. Who can carry the game harder?
Absolutely. When you've got a team like Team Silamid who have traditionally done so well to get mid lane ahead, and you talk about Xiao Wei Xiao, who's had a rough split so far, a rough season so far, it just seems like, great, let Bjergsen go carry you. Wild Turtle on Vayne also interests me quite a lot. Not a champion I've seen him play much, but, you know, again, a carry to add to the lineup here. An Impulse will let time tick down as Azir is the lock-in. Azir versus LeBlanc can be a very difficult matchup.
Yeah, that one's pretty scary for Xiao Wei Xiao. Now, he has been able to play farm lanes versus assassins fairly effectively pretty much throughout his entire career. So we'll see. This is a real test. You know, how well can you play the long-range farming versus an all-in assassin, or not even an all-in assassin, just an assassin in general in Bjergsen. The thing also, though, about that Vayne counter pick into the Sivir, I'm actually very, you know, curious to see if Wild Turtle steps up this game and can carry TSM, you know, can carry some weight. Because that is a matchup I really do like for Wild Turtle.
Absolutely.
Vayne counter pick into Sivir looks pretty good for him.
Definitely agree. She's quite strong. The one difficulty Vayne will have, though, is against Azir in team fights, where she just simply can't hit him back and get slowed around. But Wild Turtle solo killing Apollo could definitely happen this game. The question is, TSM, they're dueling. We don't typically talk about their laning strengths as far as talking about what those two players bring. Whereas we do characterize TIP's dueling as being very, very consistent. So getting that advantage may be difficult for Wild Turtle. We'll have to see as we get ourselves into the game. But before we do jump into the Rift, log on to Twitter and send your game predictions. Send either hashtag TSMWin or hashtag TIPWin to at LOL Esports. We'll be checking in to see how you're calling this game once we get the match started.
All right, let's see how TSM can do. There's the spacing of their carries is going to be very important. I just mean the positioning, the team fight spacing. Turtle and Bjergsen, they're both on very, very mobile, high DPS champions for the team fights. They're going to need to spread out. They're going to want to avoid the possibility of Rumble tagging both of them with the ultimate. That's basically all that the communication between Turtle and Bjergsen has to be, coming from different angles. Working around the AoE from Impulse, the Azir ultimate, the Impact ultimate.
Yeah.
And trying to pick apart. This is a duck and dodge team from TSM.
Well, it's thankful for TSM that, you know, since you say they do want to duck and dodge, there's not a lot of reliable hard CC for Impulse. There's no Sejuani, no Annie, no Leona. None of those bigs sit here and take a million damage, so maybe it gives room for TSM to use those mobility abilities.
That reliability factor should be on TSM's side. The Annie plus the Gnar, that should be something that TSM can count on.
Oh. Ooh, TSM got spotted coming in, and Bjergsen's cut off. TSM now stuck in the Impulse jungle. All five are around. Q hits Dyrus. And Impact is right here to put people on fire. Lustboy's losing a lot of health here. No flash hook. TSM gets out.
So neither team will be starting with a tremendous amount of information, but TSM did get a couple of the wards down. And because they saw all members of Team Impulse, they know that the response wards that you usually have to deal with on the bottom side won't be there. So TSM, because they went for that invade, because it, all members were revealed, they can swap the Vayne up onto the top side here. Is this an attempt at calling the lane swap from Impulse, though?
Early laning, I wouldn't actually like Vayne. Like,
not
really early on, Sivir can push you through. I like her after 12 minutes, but I don't think Vayne has any winning matchups in the first 10.
All right. I will take your word for it.
I could just be a worse Vayne than everyone else, and someone's going to be like, noob. Here's all the free matchups, and I'll be like, oh, you're right. Either way, Bjergsen, they're getting a lot of damage in Xiaowei Xiao, but takes like four Sand Soldier attacks for the harass. Flash for both these guys, really trying to chug through everything to deal damage here. One more minion till level two for both these mid laners.
Bjergsen working on that melee minion. Got it.
Gets answered right back.
So because we have the lane swap, of course, and because there's so much trading going on in mid lane, you gotta remember for the mid laners, the mid lane pressure comes way earlier since they can't keep track of anybody. And Xiaowei Xiao is the one shoved up on Azir, so he's pulling back very quickly, wants to get a little bit of vision down on that side, goes to ward the exit from his own jungle so that he doesn't get three-man ganked.
And everyone is safe after all is said and done. Wild Turtle is pushing the wave in very fast, the same thing we've been seeing every single team try today in the North American LCS, cut off the turret.
Yeah. A little bit safer move from TSM is that they put that lane ward down, the trinket ward, so they would see if Impulse were going to try and pull that same move of the sneak in and try and get just a couple members under the turret to soak experience.
Well, that's Xiaowei Xiao's flash, though. Everyone's still here. Barrier pop. Almost enough damage. The last tick of Ignite brings him only down to about 12 health in this one. Impact TP keeps him safe. TSM with the advantage, I think.
Woo. Checking on some more potions here as well. Xiaowei Xiao going to be able to stick around. Doesn't get either. Oh, got one.
Got two. All right. back to OK, and with the Blast Chargers and Potion still in tow, Xiao Xiao will have enough health to survive this lane, I believe.
Well, Bjergsen also still has two biscuits left.
Yeah. All right, nice by Apollo, knocks the turret down. He's sitting on about 900 gold, so he can get the pickaxe recall. That'll be answered by Vamp Scepter of Wild Turtle, most likely, as the top side of the map is getting knocked very low.
Yeah, the question is, can they finish this turret off before the reinforcements arrive? Pretty slow going here, since it still does have champion reduction, champion damage reduction.
Yeah.
And Impulse are able to grab the 1,000.
Oh.
Expecting the dodge. That was just a prediction of Lesboy backwards dodge. Adrian not able to read Lesboy's mind.
Mark of a true LCS pro player, telepathy.
We're going to start seeing Magneto helmets show up on the stage.
That's why Helmet Bro is so strong. He never truly
doesn't
dies.
He usually doesn't he usually die?
Shh.
All right, well. There still are deep TSM wards on this red side jungle, and you can see Santorin returning to that side of the jungle. The one thing that TSM did gain from that top shove is they saw Rush. Anytime that the jungler shows himself, you take away something. And Santorin wasted no time. He took away the Raptor camp. However, because they haven't seen Rush anywhere else, no one's going to be topside. Shows himself again, but Mr. Dyrus has made his way to the top side. Since his turret is down, and they really want to force this one.
They're just allowing Apollo a freeze. After that bottom lane turret went down, he never even recalled. He's just banking money, doing exactly what Hanser did last game. Just farming up and getting huge.
Dyrus does not feel safe extending pretty much ever now. So TSM made the call to concentrate all resources up top just to even up turrets. They come away with it, though. Turrets are evened up, and they have that slight gold lead. Bjergsen's got 9 for himself in the mid lane. And Santorin, hard farming, was able to take away that Raptor camp as well as one other. He's up on Rush as far as CS is going. So that's where the gold is coming from.
Dyrus down 300. The rest of the team, though, up 500 in his stead to make it a gold lead for TSM, as you point all that out.
It's pretty much, most of the rest of it is from Santorin, by the way.
Yeah.
So since Rush keeps showing himself in lanes, Santorin's taking that opportunity. I just point this out because whenever Rush gets beat Santorin, it's very visible. And everyone's like, oh my god, Rush is just crushing him. Santorin's not doing anything. This is what it looks like when Santorin beats Rush. This is what the style difference means. Comes away with CS discrepancy, and the gold lead is still very much there. It's only, 250 or so.
Sure.
Gold, but.
But still relevant.
But it's still relevant, almost as much as kill.
And we're seeing further style differences between these two junglers, by the way. It's going to be a warrior enchant for Rush versus the Cinder Hulk for Santorin. Both these junglers could have gone either way. We saw CLG do Cinder Hulk Lee Sin in their opening game, I believe. And we've seen Warrior Rek'Sai from a couple of teams as well. So, style choices abound. Santorin here to be a tank for the team. He will join up with Dyrus as the beef.
Yeah, no surprise with jungler choices. Uh-oh.
Several pop, though. They're trying to do some damage to Wild Turtle, but of course Santorin is here and forced the Warthop away from Rush. The TSM feel just safe. Bjergsen is starting to lose some health against Xiao Wei Xiao. The Azir, though, is out of mana at this time.
Santorin able to take a chunk out of Rush, and now they're pinging the invade after it. They do have a war.
Oh my god!
Alright, he's just. Oh, he's got barrier back up.
Oh! Got him!
And his flash! Oh, Xiao Wei Xiao! The ignite's still on him, and he goes for the flash. Bjergsen once again coming out with a solo kill in the mid lane. And their faith in Bjergsen grabbing him LeBlanc pays off. Xiao Wei Xiao, bold of him to go with that Azir right into the assassin, and does end up paying for it. Yes! We must mention, of course, there was the early support that Bjergsen had in the mid lane. This is TSM. They sent several resources towards mid lane to attack Xiao Xiao early and get him a small advantage in the matchup. But in the end, the one versus one where he finds the kill.
And I also do want to point out a bit of disrespect by Xiao Wei Xiao. No magic resist glyphs or anything. So he's sitting on base MR against LeBlanc. Even does an AD carry on him do that. But she's going to show up at some point. Apollo taking a fair bit of damage. Actually manages to block the Cutlass slow with the spell shield. Right. That's a minor cooldown, but looks like now as we transition later onto the game and Vayne has lifesteal, she starts doing a lot better in the matchup. Because she doesn't get like ricocheted down anymore.
Yeah, the Cutlass active used very quickly there from Turtle. So he can get the extra pressure in lane, force him to chase. Let's see here, as far as Santorin goes, coming up, oh, he is level 6 already. So he can use his network of tunnels to come up for a counter gank. Meanwhile, he's continuing with his farm. By the way, the Cinderhulk is even better at hard farming now. Yes, the damage to champions was nerfed, but it does even more damage than it did before to jungle camps and doesn't take any time to ramp up. So if you're playing this style and you're hard farming, it's much better. Okay. Lands the hook. All he gets for it is kudos. And Santorin looks to invade on the top side. He'll get a pink ward for his troubles, but all the camps are down.
Oh, ooh. Nice knocker from Xiaowei Shao. Still fighting Bjergsen. Blue buff on the LeBlanc. Takes a fair bit of damage. Still wants to do battle. Wow, those are fun fights to watch.
LeBlanc and Azir.
Ooh. The 20 minion lead for Bjergsen, by the way, after all is said and done, though. He is getting very far ahead.
Santorin is looking for a tower dive with a flash play from Rek'Sai. However, Rush is there. That is the bonus of picking Tremor Sense against Rush. Not going to make one of those risky tower dive moves since he sees two people there. Rush just lying in wait. Or actually, maybe they will bring Lesboy to the party and sway the numbers.
Yeah, Flash Tipper's likely to turn into a kill if the CC can land. Lesboy gets back in the lane in time, though, and again, we're seeing this Apollo Sivir being pushed into her turret, not really able to fight back. Santorin is here, knocks up Impact. The battle has begun. Dyrus does not have a rage bar, but Impact doesn't have a lot of a health bar either. Force run away under his turret, and the Equalizer doesn't even kill the minion.
Yeah, he doesn't get to use his Equalizer for the Wave Flare. Looks like it doesn't end up mattering in the end, though, because they back off for the Red Steel. Oh, Red's not even there. Just the Krug Steel. I feel like DSM should have pressured that Wave at the turret to try and deny Impact, since he does not have his Equalizer for CS.
Mm. Bjergsen is recalling, though, and there's the risk of Rush and Xiaowei Shao eventually being there.
I feel like it takes a long time for Azir to make his way up there.
Okay.
But fair enough. In any case, Impact will be happy scraping together a few more minions.
Yeah, he's actually holding up in minions against Dyrus. At the end of the lane swap, he was up 12. He's still at about plus 10 here, so not too bad for the Rumble. Overall, a 1,500 gold lead for Team Solo Mid, though. It's equal turret, so that's the kill and the farm lead. Once again, Bjergsen trying to make LCS big plays. Knocking down Xiaowei Shao as much as he can.
Yeah, this is a fun matchup just to watch, just because of both of them are trying to... Ooh.
Oh, Flash Tamers lands the knockup as well. Barrier's there, but he can't get over the wall. Santorin body blocks the move block.
Team Solo Mid, committing jungler and support to mid once again. Boom, get another kill. Summoner list Xiaowei Shao, easy target on the Azir having shoved up. The TSM gain the most classic of TSM advantages, mid lane pressure. Will they transition to dragon? Looks like Dyrus wants to go handle the wave that's about to head to his turret. And TSM will be content to collapse down into the river. Turtle's also got his wave shoving, so they should be able to grab this. They could have used Tibbers if they had made the call earlier. But it looks like with Santorin
right
waiting to cut off whoever goes the bottom turret, they will not go for it. Santorin was waiting up by the Grom.
Ooh, good spell shield by Apollo. Takes very little damage. He's rooted up though, and the hook on a Lustboy. A lot of damage in from Xiaowei. Xiao pushed them into the team. Apollo hit on the backside. That will be the kill picked up for Impulse though. Bottom lane turret dies at the hands of Wild Turtle. Really can't be that sad about it for TSM fans.
Yeah, they have both side lanes pushing now since Dyrus was able to get top pushing as well. And although they got the support kill for Impulse, they committed 5 people mid and they weren't able to pressure the turret afterwards. So all in all, just a small amount of gold able to be reclaimed.
Whoa! Wow, he steals the blue buff. Dyrus here to help. Santorin is tanky enough, and Wild Turtle here to deal some damage. Bjergsen cuts off Rush, the kick over the wall. Bjergsen just shows back up. Ignite in a Q, not going to give him the kill just yet, but Bjergsen still wants it. All right, that's going to do it. That's going to do it. Bjergsen gets the kill, the solo kill on the Rush. Over the wall and everything else. 3-1 TSM, 3,000 gold lead.
Yeah, what to do? I've landed my Q, but nowhere to go.
All right. Point out, there are two total assists for TSM. It's really just Bjergsen and friends running around.
Bjergsen has 100% kill participation. Big surprise. Dragon cleaned up after another job well done by Bjergsen. What a just really the move, though. That one play from TSM is a significant change from what we've seen. You know, their MSI collapse, their week one, you know, half and half sort of performance from TSM. That was an aggressive move from Santorin, backed up by the rest of the team, having the confidence, even though people were a few seconds behind, to tunnel in versus three people, grab the smite, and chase everyone out of their own jungle. This is against Team Impulse, the team with Rush as the jungler.
That's true. The winner and rookie up, or sorry, winner and runner up of rookie of the split for spring 2015. And right now, Santorin getting the much better end of it all, defending his title.
Got his worked up his small lead through, you know, hard work farming the jungle early on and a counter gank, taking away a lot of the early presence of Lee Sin. Now, he's got the stats to back it up. And he can place deep vision, getting into that jungle with a Sight Stone, pretty much matching anything Rush tries to bring.
It's interesting. So Rush has a Sight Stone and has for some time, still has his yellow trinket. So like a lot of wards able to be put down. Only one sweeper at all on the roster, but Dyrus getting caught up. Rush cannot kick him in time. Good jump by Dyrus to get out. Gank does not succeed.
Pings go down onto Santorin. Alerted to his presence, so Impact should not fall to this. Well, I guess they're just gonna wait. They don't respect Santorin's move.
Sivir ult pop, there comes the Equalizer. Santorin and Lustboy low on health, and Impact gonna get himself on the scoreboard again. Nice QQ from Rush, and Apollo cleans it up. 3-3 on the scoreboard. Impulse fire back.
We see the reason for them not being scared of Santorin there. They have more resources on the way. Hard to chase Azir. He's still got his ultimate left. Let's see if Bjergsen can pull it off.
Flash dodges the chain, but that is still the flash required for that one. Top lane turret getting hit, likely to be a kill. Teleport from Impact to hold the mid lane.
Bjergsen goes to cut off the three members of Team Impulse. Can he snipe a straggler here?
Takes some damage from Apollo. Red buff is on. Santorin turns into the ulti. Good spell shoot from Apollo.
Oh, triple knockout.
In they go. Exhaust pop to keep him alive, best they can, but Rush is the first kill. Dyrus joins in, stuns against the wall. Adrian goes down, a whole ton of kills picked up. And that's going to be Wild Turtle picking up a fourth. Great fight for TSM.
At this point, TSM beating Team Impulse across the map.
Uh-oh. Kills him. Answers back, the Ignite takes the kill. An ace for Team Solomid, 17 minutes in. Bjergsen is 6-1-1.
Whew, yeah, they had a ward onto Impact, but he doesn't care. I have flash up, and Bjergsen does go down. That's a pretty big shutdown for the Rumble. At the way that Impulse games go, though, we very rarely see comebacks from them. Let's take a look at this. Everybody joins the party. Dyrus charging up his Gnar bar, works his way up the lane, and he's able to close the distance due to Santorin using that tunnel flash knock up there to buy a little bit of time. Turtle, after leaving mid lane, is able to come in and pick up the last shot on Xiao Wei Xiao. So, basically, lane swap. They were able to weather the storm of the Lee Sin. Santorin, hard farming, outscaled him at this point. And TSM with stronger moves across the map due to their presence in mid lane. Mm-hmm. Early gank by multiple members mid lane, opening up Bjergsen to grab his solo kill. And then a return presence from Lustboy and the rest.
That all culminates in a pretty darn good for Team Solomid. Bjergsen early blue elixir, only 19 minutes into the game. But with Abyssal and Merlin Omicron already done, he feels like that's the next step to push it farther. Adrian, Ignite was up. If he used it, maybe he would have died. But mid lane still under fire. Turret number 3 in the sights for Team Solomid. They've won purely on kills so far. So Rush is forced to get away as well.
Bjergsen's still, I think, the only mid laner that I've seen in North America to go with these pre-20-minute blue elixirs. As soon as he gets, sometimes even after only an item and a half or so, he grabs one when they want to press an advantage.
Yeah, it's just whenever TSM decides we're going to start team fighting and controlling dragons, and we think 5v5s are happening, I mean, it's a great power spike. The true damage doesn't scale. You just get it, and it's just a lot. So,
if the entire team is planning on going for these moves, maybe we see, you know, Turtle grab one of the Elixirs of Wrath, I think it's called, and see if he can get some extra value out of it. Try and get the kills. Right now, though, TSM, they've got really, really deep vision on the blue buff side jungle of Team Impulse. So that means Dyrus should be playing careful. Let's play at his back.
Impulse have already set up a pretty good ward line. They actually catch Bjergsen running through the jungle. They knock him back in. Even the rush Q lands into a monster.
Oh man,
Equalizer finally turns it around. Another kill for Impact, and top lane's under fire.
They need to make this count, though, because the split pushing Vayne is taking turrets very quickly. Turtle already going to get the inner one, and is going to pressure Impact into returning to base. No ultimate on the Rumble, though.
Wild Turtle taking lessons from me from the MSI tournament. Vayne still split pushes the bot lane while his team dies. Looks good for it, though. 1-0 on him. And Impulse do manage to trade a tier 2 for the tier 2, and now they're actually walking right at Baron.
No,
they're not doing it.
No.
it just looked like it.
They were walking towards it. You're right.
Yeah. The Dragon to Team Solo mid. Turtle, Santorin, and Lustboy able to grab that one very cleanly. Solo mid looking to get even farther ahead. They're sitting on 2 dragons to 0, a 5,000 gold lead at 21 minutes. A lot of sizable advantages for this team in blue.
Let's see if Impulse can use that Sivir speed to outmaneuver TSM. They do need to find a fight with a number advantage. It's going to be fairly difficult, though, because the vision coverage for TSM is complete. They only have one quadrant of the map that they do not have perfect intel on, and that is this red buff side of Team Impulse. All they have to do is avoid that area. They can draw Impulse out onto the map fairly quickly here. If they just clean Baron up a little bit, and they can try and force Impulse out into their hands. Fog of War is definitely your friend when you're working with LeBlanc.
Oh, true.
As well as a 6-2 LeBlanc. Bjergsen can easily 100-0 anyone who walks too close. Anyone on this team, by the way, because they don't have a chain.
No, or any magic resist items. You've got a Giant's Belt and a Null Magic Mantle on Rush, and that's the sum total of his tank items, so. Yeah, squishy lineup for sure. Bjergsen has his pick of the litter for who he wants to assassinate in this game.
There we go. Move all of your vision over to the Baron side of the map. Set it up. LeBlanc can make some picks. They can gain a whole bunch of pressure on Baron because they have Vayne on their squad.
Oh, God.
Vayne plus Rek'Sai and Gnar can easily take Baron while LeBlanc sits in Fog of War looking for an ambush. Prepping the minion waves here. Dyrus and Turtle doing their side lane duty. Getting those ready.
Man, right now the gold on TSM is focused on... Jeez. The gold on TSM is focused on 3 really big carries. Bjergsen, Wild Turtle, and Santorin all have more gold than the richest member of TIP. Even though a few of them have quite a lot of farm and a couple of kills, there's massive advantages. Apollo, yet again, good spell shield.
All right, they've got double pinks in the river for Baron. Red side of the jungle warded up. Bottom lane will be pushing. Outer turret, or secondary turret down there. Pretty clean here as far as execution for TSM. Yeah.
Let your TP go on the other side of the map. The rest of your team wants to be near the next big objective, which in this case is Baron on the top side. And then stay together. Find people in your network of wards. Bjergsen and Santorin find Rush kicked back. He's gonna dash away. Nice play by Rush to get out of this one. And they're actually chasing Dyrus with a Sivir ulti.
Dyrus has a prepped Gnar bar, though. It's just hovering close to Mega Form. So he's ready to teleport in at any moment. And Team Impulse rightly back off. They do not want to take a fight in that jungle, where TSM has set up their vision now. Turret does end up going down, and it looks like they're going to get off another purchase before they go for a Baron bait. They could just continue split pushing, but the only secondary turret that they can really do is mid, so probably see some more control around the red buff side of the jungle.
And you're seeing TIP rather have to go as a group just to put a couple of wards down. TSM have strangled vision pretty well, although off the recalls, Impulse gets some time to get it back.
Yeah. That mid secondary turret is pretty much the hardest for TSM to crack, because they don't really do all that well grouped up as five in a corridor against Team Impulse. With the Azir and Rumble, you don't want to give them any openings to be able to get a good combo off. So TSM rightly focusing on neutrals, taking away the blue here. You don't want Azir to have that. See if they go back over to clear vision on Baron, though, or if they actually try and make the split push work.
Well, I like, though, you talked, when you talked about the gravity games from last week, where they were splitting their attention in a lot of different places, TSM are making concerted efforts in one spot at a time. They all go to blue buff, clear that away. They've got enough wards to make sure Baron's not getting snuck, whatever. Okay, blue's done. Go back to the split push. Narc, go to the bot lane. The rest of us can cross back to the other side of the map.
Yeah.
Set up Baron, get again.
I feel like where they can gain most advantage is clearing out all the vision around Baron and trying to bait. This LeBlanc is so scary for all members of Team Impulse right now. Fog of War is the stuff of nightmares at the moment. So, they send Turtle to prep the top wave, and we'll see if they swing from mid over there. Down to Baron. Yeah.
Looks like TSM really haven't made a concerted effort for setting up Baron, though. It's primary goal, keep the mini waves in good shape. That's done well so far. Secondary goal has been taking easy-to-grab objectives. It was the blue buff. Now it's Dragon in a minute. They've managed to take the last 3 minutes just clearing out buffs and prepping for Dragon number three.
Yeah, I guess they will take the safer route. Dragon, a much more tame beast.
It seems like TSM are basically prodding at any mistakes, and if Impulse screw up, they'll go in.
Yeah, Bjergsen's constantly looking for poke on anybody who gets too close. He goes in with just the WQR combo. Maybe he lands his chain, maybe he doesn't, don't really care, because just that initial combo is going to be a big chunk out of anyone. He's keeping them bottled up inside their base, pretty much. And the longer that you keep Team Impulse bottled up inside this base, you're gaining a huge amount of income across the map here, controlling pretty much both sides of jungle.
Hook from Adrian, not followed up on. No one else was there.
From Impulse's point of view, though, they're really just waiting for an opportunity to have a five versus something less than five pick and pop the Sivir ultimate. But TSM are not giving that to them because they are traveling in a pack.
And they've moved the solo from solo mid right here. The whole group is here.
Fight in the mid would be some good open territory for TSM to work with. Getting chunked out there for Bjergsen, though, down to half life. They do not force the issue.
See where they head to next. Bjergsen recalls after getting chunked, going towards death cap, so no Luden's build on him. You know, we see a couple of different builds. Yeah, a big wave bot, which Dyrus could easily clear. Of course, he's a blue trigger to see that Impulse are not, in fact, going for Baron. But that was a bit of a risk. Nice bait there by TIP.
Yeah, honestly, there's not a lot of threat behind that bluff.
That's true.
But good of TSM not to face check. Use a scrying orb there from Turtle and the Prey Seeker.
And so, TSM have a big wave pushing out top lane. They send the Gnar after all to go clear bot, so Dyrus will continue to get some more farm as he builds tanky. A good mix of armor and magic resist, as Apollo and Impact are both pretty scary in this one. Zonya's done for the Rumble, means he can zone people out even better, and I wonder if TSM will wait for this death cap combined. 300 gold away on Bjergsen.
Oh, interesting too. Second item, defensive item here, Cowl for Turtle.
Yeah.
On the Vayne. He's got plenty of power with the Phantom Dancer plus Blade of the Rune King. And with the double solo lane APs, looking to stay safe.
So no meaningful attempts on Baron still for solo mid. They are just giving. And the thing is, like, they had this 5,000 gold lead for so long. Like, now it's 6,000 gold, but it took 7 minutes to grow that by 1K.
They did get another dragon.
Yeah, but that's still another 12 minutes away to go for Dragon 5. This feels overly slow to me from Team Solo mid. Just a touch.
I feel like they would be able to get a Fog of War pick if they really focused. Here's
mid
lane,
there's the
though.
Hard engage. Speaking of overly slow, in they go. They pick up Adrian, and Impact might be next. Flash the way, Summoner heal. Here comes the Flash engage, but everyone kicks him back. Still a double kill for Bjergsen.
Oh, Turtle's trapped.
He is very trapped. They can't get over the wall. That's going to be a kill. Finally answered back. The Azir turret of Xiao Wei Xiao helping quite a bit.
How did he get in there? What the heck?
Oh my god, Bjergsen, his third kill of the fight. 9-2-1. Doing all the heavy lifting for TSM.
All right, that should definitely be Baron for TSM. Like they're focused
without
on
an AD carry, I don't think they can.
Looks like they're focused on turrets. I guess so. I mean, Bjergsen. Yeah. All right. They're gonna get the turrets instead. The turrets are really hard for them to get down, so they see the opportunity to get a turret, they'll take it. But again, they're gonna have to make another. Oh, jeez. I am curious about that replay to see how Turtle got himself inside a divide there. But Bjergsen putting out the massive deeps, able to clean up the fight for TSM. So all in all, TSM another victory. Let's take a look here. So this is one of their picks. Yes, they were cleaning Baron. Move over, sideswipe them. There's the Righteous Glory from Lesfoy, able to get a beautiful Tibber stun there and force this. After taking out one, all of Impulse on the run. Okay, so Dyrus gets knocked out of it. Turtle.
Does he flash?
Flashes into it. That's how he gets in there. As expected, Turtle. He got the kill.
No, it actually went over to Bjergsen.
Oh, he did?
He didn't get anything.
Did he get an assist even?
I don't even know if the. He has 3 assists now, so yes, the 3 kills were assisted by Wild Turtle, but I'm going to say not worth.
Yeah. How'd Turtle get in there? Ah, he flashed in. Yeah.
He flashed in to die and not even do any damage. That sounds like Wild Turtle.
He does get bored.
Well, it's true. That's how he plays.
Split pushing.
Hey man, if I had 295 minions, I just feel good about myself. I don't care about kills and deaths. I just want farm. At home, my keyboard actually shows my gold per minute because it like hooks into League of Legends. If I have over 400, I'm just like, I don't care. I did what I wanted.
Awesome.
Yep. I'm not a good teammate.
I know, we played ranked 5.
I just play Fiora and stay top lane.
Well, like TSM gonna try and stay around Baron. Looks like they will try and bait in Impulse again because inhibitor turrets, trying to siege up one of those is just not an option for them. They could try and gain another side lane advantage with a split push to prep this Baron work they're doing, but
jeez,
the Bjergsen poke is substantial.
But Impulse have the inside track on the mid lane. Depends on how good the sideswipe is from Team Solo mid. Sivir ulti from Apollo can always be used to reposition and get out of hairy situations. Lustboy's flash is down despite his distortion boots. So a bit more time has been gained here. Lustboy's heading towards Talisman of Ascension, by the way. That's what that forbidden idol is going to be for. And as he sits on 400 gold, he's got a long road ahead for that item, but more move speed is soon for TSM.
Good. They'll be able to make a play. Hey, that Vayne and Rek'Sai are doing work on Baron as well. All this action goes. See if they've bought enough time.
Sivir pop the TP from Impact. Baron goes down, but the entire team's at half health. Will they follow through? TSM looking to re-engage, maybe through the box, but this could be a good equalizer. This is the fight that you're going to have to watch for. Zonya popped by Impact. Sivir times out, lanterns him away. No stun from Dyrus. Is this the time that Impulse finally turns it back around? Dyrus getting kicked. There's the equalizer, 1-0. Is there follow-up? Wild Turtle forced to run away. Dyrus just buys enough time for his team to disengage safely.
Well, Dyrus got left hung out to dry there, so there was some discord in TSM communication there as he gets a little bit too far forward and the rest of the team not willing to commit to that.
Dragon's up for Impulse, and at this stage of the game, finally getting a Dragon at 33 minutes is a huge boost.
That was great for Impulse. They were able to not only grab that 6% attack damage and ability power for themselves, but also delay the number 5 from TSM. And they bought themselves a bit longer to huddle inside the turrets. The Baron and the Dragon both off of the field. Nothing to draw Impulse away from their turret defense game. They've just bought a tremendous amount of time for themselves. We'll see if, though, if the split push, the Baron-empowered split push, if TSM are finally able to, you know, at least take some cracks out of those inhibitor turrets. But
yeah,
Wild Turtle's definitely up to the task, going immediately for the split push. TSM definitely wants to
use gonna beat
the
him?
Baron buff.
There's no one here that's going to win the 1v1 against him. I think Rush still has room to go.
Yeah, your only hope is to wave clear at the turret. Sivir or Azir will probably have to take up duty and just deal with a tower dive if he decides to go with a tower dive.
Well, we'll see what happens. Right now, that first dragon buff adding a lot of stats, but Baron adding just a little bit more.
Cooldowns out of Xiao Xiao. The Azir ultimate is a huge part of the turret defense. So Bjerg's in there able to weaken the defenses of Team Impulse.
Very true.
With a good solo play. We'll see if that does translate into an inhibitor turret going down, though.
It seems unlikely. Bjerg needs to get some poke over the wall or something. Get another blue elixir, right click once in a while. Death Cap and Void Staff now done on him. I think he can one-shot everyone but Lee Sin on a full combo. So watch out for that. Bjergsen can absolutely evaporate someone. You have to keep wards over the wall. Impulse have to put them over the wall to see when Bjergsen's coming in, or they'll get killed from Fog of War. You're seeing one ward right there. That's exactly what Impulse need. And
yeah.
Just clear it away.
This is the test here for Team Impulse. They've had a hard time coming back from games where they get an early deficit, where they don't start out, you know, with strong early moves from Rush. Ooh. They're making their stand here. Let's see if they can do it. Quickly back to base. Everybody should be getting home guards for Impulse at this point. And the shove runs through.
Gets away from Adrian, half health on him, and a good amount of damage. TSM stays to knock down the turret right as Dyrus goes Meganar. Lantern out on the Sivir. There comes the re-engage. The Bjergsen clone trying to buy some time. Eclipse onto the back line, but down goes Lee Sin. Bjergsen gets traded back. That's like all the kills of TSM. The gold left on the map, actually, quite a bit lower now. TSM get away safely.
Yeah, and the front line got chunked out. Santorin's extremely low. Dyrus down, so they lose the inhibitor turret. They do not lose their inhibitor impulse. They at least won't have to deal with the super minions coming in at the moment, but the door is open for TSM in the bottom lane now. So split pushing, probably still on the menu for TSM.
Absolutely. Now, of course, a long time to go for Dragon 5, but with complete map control, Baron 2 is only 3 minutes away.
And this is a curious situation for Impulse. Usually they win fast or they lose fast because they keep trying things in the mid-game if they start to get behind and the lead of their opponents gets out of hand very quickly.
Yes, Flash. Nice, he's already ready for the Flash, stands in the correct spot. One more crit would have killed him. Nice try by Wild Turtle.
Yeah, he saw it coming. Instant Scrying Orb, but no crits. No crits, no kill.
He actually missed a possible auto attack. You can pretty much do an instant reset by tumbling into a wall, and I don't believe his first attack came out in time. So he could have gotten the 3 hits in Silver Bolt proc. Close. But hundreds of seconds off. Wow, a little bit of damage onto Bjergsen, but a lot more on a Xiao Wei Xiao. And he's still not bought any Madricus, by the way. Xiao Wei Xiao doesn't care about defensive stats, and he gets chunked out every single fight because
his philosophy is basically, if Bjergsen lands a combo on me, I'm going back to Fountain anyway. And I haven't died from it yet, so
his defensive item is home guards. I guess that works.
Exactly.
More damage in the turret. Lustboy does not get hooked. Rushed down to half from Bjergsen.
All right, so this, you know, funnel point that the opening to the base does provide is something that Impulse can work with. They can set up Azir soldiers at the front, and they have a Rumble ultimate. So Xiao Xiao is on guard duty here. Sand soldiers just patrolling the entrance to their base, trying to fend off TSM's assault.
They're even warming up. Like, boxing at shadows, like, this is gonna happen to you if you walk forward. Better check yourself.
Oh.
The Azir Soldiers.
I got it.
Yeah, yeah. We're good. All right, Dyrus going to be holding up the top lane for now. He seems to be the one always chosen in case things push in without TSM realizing in time. Still, of course, Bjergsen and Wild Turtle are the ones who clear the waves first if they get the chance. They're given all the gold. Dyrus gets the scraps, but it's enough to be tanky. 0-1-5 in a 40-minute game. Only one death. Not bad at all. Impulse get the rare chance to clear their own jungle as TSM had all just recalling. Recalling? Recalled?
So when both the objectives come out at the same time here, Impulse... Oh, actually, I don't think Impulse have the timer for the dragon, so they could try and go for the trade and at least get a dragon out of giving up Baron to TSM, because I think that going into Fog of War is just too risky for them. But they actually, I don't think they got the timer on Dragon, so they might not even be able to trade.
They're heading over that way, though, after they cleared out mid lane. TSM made sure they had wards on Baron first, and then went to go contest Dragon. Mid lane, though, has to be cleared first away, so TSM still playing by the numbers, a slow, controlled style where they are not giving up a chance to split push, they are not giving a random siege any room to start. This is on top of Scuttlecrab. Wild Turtle is seen doing this, so Impulse will show up.
It's not fast.
Baron's nearly dead. 2,000 health picked up by TSM. There it is. Now, here's the flash engage. They catch Impact, stunned to the wall. He had no chance to do anything, and TSM take him down.
All right, Baron buff. There's the big play for TSM. Impact down. They can probably shove all the way to the Nexus through bottom lane.
That's exactly where they go, right away. Who cares about clearing mid? We can win the game without Rumble. 40 seconds on the respawn. Wild Turtle shows up first. Mid lane gets cleared by Bjergsen. He's going to show up soon, though, and Dyrus barely even cares about this damage coming in.
Banshee's Veil popped. That's step number one for taking down Turtle.
All right. Well, step number two and three have enough damage, and with Impact Dead, that's probably not going to happen. Bottom and hip goes down to TSM. Take the slow road one more time. They're going to go for Dragon 4.
So another waiting game. Clean the map. Grab the neutral. So do you really care more about minion kills than you do about actual kill streak? I don't find that hard to believe.
You don't find that hard to believe?
I find it hard to believe.
Yeah. No, I know. I just say things for exaggeration's sake.
A PvE player?
Like, for example, most things don't really deal tons of damage. They just deal large amounts.
How much does one damage weigh?
Let's go 1 pound per foot of damage.
Are we talking metric ton?
No. Okay. We're in America.
Just checking.
When we say football, it means the weird round oblong thing with field goals.
The egg.
Yeah, hand egg. That's what football is.
All right, well, we got the triple Baroned up cannons trying to do work on the top side.
Where's
here.
The banner of command, Lost Boy?
As TSM make work.
It's so pretty.
Five members collapse. Here they go.
Oh, man. Down goes Adrian. Solo kill again for Bjergsen, sitting on 11 for himself. Top and hip drops as well. Four cannons now in tow. Pop the Zonias from Impact. He's forced away. Two and hips down. Minions battering on the front door. TSM going to go ahead and knock down the third and hip turret. Milking all the fantasy points there for owners of Team TSM. Azir drops. Everyone's dying now. Impact can't do anything, nor can Apollo. This is going to be absolutely GG. Solomid answered back that they can defeat a top four team, and they will do so against Team Impulse here.
Woo! Bjergsen on that LeBlanc as well. What a great game from him. TSM, they went back to focusing mid lane, throw a few resources over there, ganks from multiple people, support ganks as well. Bjergsen takes that advantage happily and turns it into many kills in the mid lane.
12-3-3. Not only was he at 15 of 17 kill participation, he had more kills than the entire enemy team. He had more kills than anyone else on his team had assists. Just that game is, if you want to know how TSM plays and why they're good, it is exactly that. Bjergsen got some help and then solo kill after solo kill after solo kill.
Yeah. We'll practice the top lane focus game style for a week to make you happy, Dyrus. First team Impulse second week LCS, TSM do have a strong competition. This week around, they've got a strong schedule. CLG tomorrow. So
yeah.
Very excited to see what they pull out for that one.
And you know, as we talk about what kind of League of Legends these teams are playing, you know, these teams definitely have different styles, generally speaking, week to week. Impulse, we said, is the team with Chaos, right? They want to play Yasuo and Fizz. They got banned this game. They got banned the last game they played against CLG as well. And when you're stuck with the regular team fighting mid like Azir for Xiao Wei Xiao, and then no reliable hard engage to make team fights happen, all you're doing is letting this force for Chaos, this LeBlanc, run around and basically out team Impulse.
Yeah, they were able to control Vision TSM because they had that good start, and just that one outpost of control of the mid lane there, just sending a couple ganks mid, they were really able to control Rush. Rush didn't get to do anything on his Lee Sin, the signature champion here for him. Wasn't able to make the early game play happen. Santorin out-farmed him during that early game because of the lane swap. You know, it was something that Rush had to adjust to coming to the competitive scene from solo queue. He did a fairly good job of adjusting to it last split, but this time TSM just did a better job.
Yeah, Suleiman did a great job playing the second half of the lane swap, even though first turret had gone over to Team Impulse. But as we talked about with this game, Bjergsen was absolutely massive. We actually, just for fun, we have a good kill montage from Bjergsen. He had 12 of them throughout this game. So this is the first solo kill. Xiao Xiao actually has all summoners up at this point.
He's got a lot of life as well. All right, let's roll this clip. Take a look here. Bjergsen is chugging on the mana potions. All in potential. Oh, he instantly clears the wave with
that's
WR so
awesome.
That he can guarantee landing the chain.
Yeah, that was really good. I didn't see that one coming. He's like, how's he land the rest of the combo? He clears everything away. And then here, even though Rush kicks him over the wall.
The chain still goes.
Yeah. Chain still hits him. If you are back in a range, the fact that he chases this too, like Rush flashed into his own turret and Bjergsen's like, no, it's fine.
If you take the Q, then he guarantees to land the chain as well. But if his chain was on cooldown, I feel like Rush should have taken that, because if you W into him and Lee Sin connects, the model connects for Q, then you get the damage.
Yeah, and I mean, the W has to hit the ground, so you can theoretically even go through it as well. But more coming in. This is actually just like really good engage or attempted engage by Dyrus, good reflexes by Impulse, but
Double kill.
Just Bjergsen kills everyone. He gets another one on the back end as well.
There's Turtle. Ignore that bottom right-hand corner.
Doesn't matter.
Bjergsen comes in for another snipe, though.
Over the wall.
Bjergsen was at, Turtle was actually just a distraction.
Flash R cues him at the backside.
He even landed the chain.
He landed the E on Xiao Wei Xiao. All right. I missed that one, too. So as we've seen today, Bjergsen's quite good at League of Legends. Maybe one of the bigger understatements said today. But yeah, solo mid improved to 2-1.
Wild Turtle still wild.
Wild Turtle still incredibly wild. Still managed to keep himself to only one death. That was his only death the entire game. So, you know, golf clap for Wild Turtle to not get himself killed more often in that one. But it was Impulse, you know, kind of unfortunately playing the way we've now expected them to, where it's like Impact does really, really well. Unfortunately, he got focused out later on. The bot lane was still consistent. At the very beginning of the game, Apollo was like 2-1-3 or something, and Adrian has a similar scoreline. Like, those two signs of the map did very well, but Xiao Wei Xiao doesn't respect Bjergsen. No MR glyphs. He brought barrier, but still got solo killed multiple times, and we're missing things from the sort of central part of Impulse in a lot of these games.
Yeah, and a lot of that mid pressure did come from the bottom lane, Les Boy roaming. So
yeah,
you have to factor that into the bottom lane performance as well.
And they gave a self-sufficient AD carry the Wild Turtle to make that one happen. But now we're going to hand it off to Dash at the analyst desk for a word with